Good afternoon, all the jury members and all the participants who are listening. My topic is basically a review study. It is based on the determination of stability of DNA samples that are being stored in the blood, in the form of bloods and bloodstain samples. Basically, the study is being conducted under the supervision of Dr. Sally Lukos. She is Dean in Sharda University. Kindly move to the next slide, please. These are the contents through which my study will move forward. Basically, whenever we talk about the crime scenes and its collection of physical evidences from the crime scenes, when we talk about the biological evidences, the basic evidences will actually, they correlate the crime scenes with the suspects and the victims. The biological evidences out of which blood and blood stains are quite important with the perspective of the DNA collections or forensic DNA analysis, which is actually dependent on the basis of collections from the persons and bloods from the crime scenes in the liquid states or wet blood stains to be collected or dried blood stains from the crime scenes. Sorry. Basically, it's the storage and transportation of blood or of whole blood samples and the blood stain samples are quite important. And there are many storage and transportation patterns, as well as after the storage and transportation of the blood samples and the samples to be collected for the forensic DNA analysis, the DNA extraction is quite important method to be done and to be undergone. That is basically the general process or steps to be followed are cell disruptions, cell lysis, then removal of protein and other cytoplasmic contents, and then the storage of DNA solutions. The theme of my study on which my study was being based is basically the whole blood samples or blood stains that are being retrieved from the crime scenes, they act as important source for DNA for any purpose, any short tandem repeat analysis or many other forensic analysis. Basic several biological evidences, wherever we collect the biological evidences, they undergo various changes and shows various degraded DNA samples on the extraction when the extraction is being conducted. Another factor is there is the influence of the collection and the storage conditions of blood samples that are being retrieved from the crime scenes on the DNA degradation part. Another important part is the methods that are being used for the purpose of DNA isolation. It is also having an impact on the extractions of DNA. The objectives of my studies, if you'll see, the objectives were basically the review and studies that we have encountered for the study is to assess the impact of collection and storage methods, that what are the impacts of collections and storage methods of whole blood samples or blood stains for the DNA analysis, and to evaluate the effect of storage temperatures and storage durations on the of whole blood samples and blood stains on DNA degradations. Then to assess the impact of different preservatives that are being used for the whole blood samples collections on the DNA extraction yields, and also to compare the best commonly used genomic DNA extraction methods that is quite useful for all the sort of extractions and useful for DNA analysis that fulfill all the basic needs for it. Next. The methodology, if we'll talk about the methodology that were followed by the researchers for this purpose were sample collections. I have basically segregated it in the form of collections, temperatures, durations, and extraction methods, and then the analytical techniques on the basis of which they have proved their results. Next, please. Yes. First of all, talking about the sample collections, the study showed that the sample collections were basically conducted by three different forms. That is, the blood-soaked cotton gauges were used for the purpose of collections and forwarding it to the forensic laboratories. Then it was collected from wherever the samples were collected from, directly from the people. It was collected in the heparin and EDTA tubes. And another factor where it was used, was FTA cards. FTA cards are basically the Flint technology associate cards that are quite useful for the storage of DNA samples and for the transferring of DNA samples for the forensic analysis. Next, please. Yes. The storage temperatures and durations that were found to be evident, it was found that temperatures that were used for the purpose of these studies were the storage at room temperatures, at 4 degrees Celsius temperatures, at minus 20 degrees and at minus 80 degrees Celsius temperatures. Also, the storage durations were encountered. I have encountered many studies where it was found that the storage short-term storage durations work were quite evident in the field, and literature was there for 1 to 2 years or 6 months to 1 month, 2 months of studies, but there were less long duration studies. And the extraction methods that were commonly used were the phenol chloroform extraction methods and the silica gel based extraction methods that were quite used in the studies. Next, please. The analytical techniques that were being used for the purpose of identification of concentration and purities of the sample extracted using these above mentioned methods were UV visible spectrophotometry and spectrofluorometry, and the integrity of the extracted DNA samples were measured using the agarose gel electrophoresis techniques. Now, talking about the results and discussions, it is quite evident that the extraction methods that were used for the purpose of extracted DNA, for the purpose of analyzing the purity of the extraction DNA, it was found that the silica-based as well as the phenol chloroform method that were used for the extraction method, it was found that the amount or the value of the extraction methods of this ratio, A260 nanometer to 280 nanometers, as well as A260 nanometers to 213 nanometers ratio was around 1.8 for the DNA samples, and it is to be considered as the purest sample for the DNA. And it was found that the extracted DNA from silica-based and phenol chloroform methods, they provided the good quality or good pure quality of DNA from extracted with this process. Then the storage conditions, EDTA basically gave good percentage of integrated DNA at 4 degrees Celsius. Although when we talk about the heparin tubes used for the same purpose, they gave the results for the good integrated DNAs for at least for only 9 to 10 days. It was evident that for the heparin tubes used for more than 10 days at 4 degrees Celsius gave less less extraction yield and integrated DNA. On the other hand, ETTA for 130 days when stored for at 4 degrees Celsius, it gave quite good evident results and was stored. One study, I've presented the result in the form of graph, where Orta et al. In his study, he actually used biostabilizing techniques using DNA stable blood and DNA guard bloods, which was indicative that the storage temperature of the human blood was quite evident for 2 months, and it shows the purity and good quality in the extraction yield of DNA sample when the biostabilizing techniques were used with EDTA tubes, not with the heparin tubes. The EDTA tubes were actually were added with the DNA biostabilizers, and it provided the good quality of DNA samples. Next, please. Yes, Hara et al. Basically is a scientist. He worked in this field for 20 years, and he provided the study where he had actually conducted the study for blood stains as well as for blood samples. For blood stains, he stored the sample at room temperatures 4 degrees Celsius, minus 20 and minus 80 degrees Celsius. On the other hand, the whole blood samples were stored at minus 20 as well as minus 80 degrees Celsius. And when the study is being conducted, it was found that the 129 ratio with 41 base pairs and 305 to 41 base pairs, it was found that the EDTA tubes used for this study and showed the blood stains as well as whole blood samples showed quite good results in the minus 20 as well as minus 80 degrees Celsius. Next, please. Yeah, this is the study conducted by Kaur et al. In 2020 itself from Forensic Science Laboratory. She has presented the good quality of storage and preservation of samples, as well as the bad quality of storage samples that are being collected by the police officials and transferred to the forensic laboratories. In the above diagram, in the above figure, you can see clearly that A 260 and 280 ratio is basically 1.78, that is approximately 1.8, and that's why the collected samples were considered as the good quality stored and preserved samples. On the other hand, the samples in the below figure, we can see the average of ratio of A260 to 280 ratio was around 1.2, and this was quite evident that these samples were bad quality collected and they were not collected preserved properly by the police officials and was not reached at the forensic laboratory at the time. And when it is reached and the analysis was done, they found it, the fungal growths, the contaminated samples, and many other forward things. Next, please. Yeah, talking about the conclusions on my of my studies, they were based on the samples that must be properly air dried before the packaging and transported to the forensic laboratories, as well as whenever the stabilizing techniques could also be used for at the room temperatures for immediate storage of DNA samples whenever it is collected and retrieved from the crime scenes, because the biostabilizers are quite useful for storing the samples with the EDTA tubes. The EDTA was actually founded to provide good quality of DNA comparative to heparin up to 50 days. It was found the EDTA is quite evident, useful. And whenever for the purpose of preliminary blood examinations and for the purpose of forensic DNA analysis, the Hara et al. Basically was a scientist. He considered the blood examinations for preliminary. He found it that dried blood stains stored for the sampling were quite useful for the preliminary examinations as well, when compared to the whole blood sample stored. Another is the phenol chloroform extraction method was also useful for the purpose of extractions. Now, if we'll talk about this further studies, the collection of blood samples from the crime scene, it can many times found to be difficult using the gauze pieces. Then the cotton swabs can also be considered for this purpose and for the purpose of preliminary examinations. Impact of adding the biostabilizers also to the blood samples stored in EDTA tubes before the storage period. It could also be these studies could also be done for the purpose of studies of forensic DNA analysis, as well as phenol chloroform extraction method is time taking and bears various sample transfer, which can cause contaminations as well. So there are many modified extraction methods that could also be used for this purpose. Another thing is many studies that I've also mentioned earlier, that there are many studies that are based on the short-term durations and extraction methods. The study should also be considered to be done for the purpose of long storage methods of DNA solutions and blood storage, so that the less degraded amount of DNA could be utilized or examined whenever we talk about the re-examinations part in the forensic. Next, please. These are the references for my studies. Yes, thank you all.